Hello, mga kabamiyo. We are currently at Destino Beach Club Dive Resort and Hotel. So thank you so much for taking the time out of your summer to once again tune into our show. My name is Angela C. I am the Associate Managing Editor of ABS-CBN Lifestyle and host of this series you're watching called Man Crush Mondate, where we give you guys the chance to get to know up-and-coming actors, models, singers, athletes, and influencers on a really personal level while giving you guys a chance to get to see them do a little something different at the same time. And because this is a show, we want to invite you guys to send us your comments, your shout outs, most especially your questions for who I'm about to bring out as our man crush of the week. So acting runs in this guy's blood, but he's already made a name for himself in his craft. And from starring in commercials as a kid to showcasing his talents in theater to now being one of five sexy leads in Los Bastardos. Here with me now is none other than him himself, Josh Colet. Hi!
Hi! Just nice enjoying the ice cream.
You. I know, my God, you've already started. I'm gonna start eating.
Start,
as well.
Come on, cheers.
I know, cheers.
Cheers.
How are you?
Hi, guys. I'm good, really good. Super nice resort. Destino, right? Destino.
Yeah.
Destino Resort.
Is it your first time here?
First time here. Thank you, everybody at Destino, for having us here. Super nice, super exclusive resort. And it's like a hidden paradise, to be honest. So I'm really happy to be here. It's like I'm not even working right now. So, how about you?
You must be busy.
Yeah, actually. Yesterday, we just came from a mall show. So usually we tape TTHS. Mall show Sunday. You know, I still consider Tuesday, Thursdays as work because I spend most of my time in the gym, you know, just to maintain, you know, that physique for TV because we have to do it and everything. So aside from that, I study after gym, scene study, try to find new ways to attack my role. And it's super fun and I don't really see it as work. I'm super entertained by it and I'm really passionate about it. So I just want to thank everybody who's helped get me here where I am right now. Super sobrang saya. Pwede naman mag Tagalog, diba?
Yeah, pwede naman.
Pwede naman mag Tagalog. Oh, kumusta guys? Tatagalog na lang ako. So, gusto ko magpasalamat sa lahat ng everybody who helped out talaga. And if it weren't for most of you guys, the production, Direk Ruel, Bayani, if it weren't for you, I wouldn't be here right now. So, grabe talaga. Thank you so much. And it's been a really, really fun journey. Wait lang, ang gulo na buhok ko.
Oh, yung wind, diba?
The wind and everything. So, ikaw, how are you?
I'm good.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm the type who always, like, loved the beach and
the summer weather.
You know? So, today is, like, the most perfect day.
Exactly.
And I'm a huge fan of sweets, so...
Sweet tooth.
Yeah, super bad sweet tooth.
Magnum's really good.
Yeah, really good.
The same, you know, usually I spend my time at the beach. It's my favorite place to spend time, talaga. Just sit on the beach and just watch the waves, you know. I'm that kind of guy who just chills on the beach. So nothing special, really. Just a breather for me, especially because of how busy our schedules are and everything. So whenever we have time to go out, beach is always on the top of the list. Yeah, so... really enjoy it. That's why now I'm like super chill.
Nice. Okay. What's this? While we're here, the way that usually our show works is that I'm going to be reading off questions that have already been coming from your fans.
Okay.
Since we've started airing, and then all you have to do is answer them. Sounds good?
Sounds good.
Perfect. Okay.
Sounds good.
First is from Sean. I'm sorry, there's hair in my mouth. He goes, what's a day like on the set of Los Bastardos?
Oh my god, super fun. It's like, okay, let me put it this way.
Yeah, it's give me the rundown.
It's like when I go on set, it's like a gathering of your barcada. It's like that every single day. It's just, it's not, it's like you're not working. You go there to see your friends and enjoy your time with them. At the same time, all of you share that passion for your craft. So all of you, you know, just jive together. And hindi nakakapagod. So pag nandun ako, parang kahit na buong araw kami nandun hanggang umaga, hindi siya nakakapagod because you love what you're doing. You love what you're doing. And the support, grabe. Since the beginning of the show, you know, there are some shows that say, sometimes, you know, there are actors who think about themselves, you know, who don't really support their fellow actors and everything. They just focus. They just focus on themselves. Here, everybody works together to make the show great. And that's what makes shows really good, is if all the actors, all the artists, the production, the directors, the producers, they all work together, they collaborate to make something really beautiful. So that's Los Bastardos for you guys. And wow. You know, marami pang aabangan, marami pang mangyayari, and abangan niyo yan. Kakain muna ako ng ice cream ko. Natutunaw na.
Mine din. Okay. Next comes from Queen MC.
Oh.
The question is, what's your favorite part of your body? I'm sure you've been focusing a lot on your body because of the show. Like, everything that I've seen, like, promoting Los Bastardos, like, you guys are shirtless, like, muscles out, sweating. So, what do you love about it most?
Well, you know, from a business point of view, I guess.
Business point of view, muna.
You know, whenever you step in something, whenever you do something, you want to be different from all the other people, you know? You get what I mean?
Okay.
Like, you want to give something different. So, me, it's my arms. My arms, because I've worked hard to develop my body, you know. I was raised, my dad was a bodybuilder before. So I started young, started building my body and everything. So I'm proud of my arms because in show business, you don't really get that a lot, you know. They're more of the lean abs type of thing, but then, you know, I want to break that stigma. Give a little mass, diba? A little chunkiness to the scene. So from a business point of view, that's different, and that's one of my favorite parts of my body because that differentiates me from all the other guys. But then my personal favorite is are my eyes. It's different as well. But
they are. Yeah. Like, I'm looking at them right now. They're so green.
Yeah. So, yeah. I love my eyes and I'm proud of them. So, yeah. It's my favorite part of my body.
Okay. I really like the answer because you have, like, two sides to it.
Mm-hmm.
The business.
Business.
And the professional. And the professional. Very interesting. Okay, next is from Irish.
Hi, Irish.
Asks, what's the most memorable project you've had so far?
Los Bastardos.
Really?
Los Bastardos.
And you've had a lot, like.
I've had a lot throughout my life. Theater.
Yeah, exactly.
I started being extra MMK.
Extra, like.
Extra, like, you know, just. Small roles, no speaking lines, background lang, ganon. So I started with that. Those were memorable because those were, like, you know, starting days. But then right now, this, for me, the best time of my life. It's my break in my career, Los Bastardos, and everything just fell into place. And I'm so passionate about everything. You know, when Los Bastardos started, I kind of locked myself. You know, kept to myself because I really wanted to do good. And my character required me to, like, get deeper inside myself. To the point where nadadala ko yung character ko. Kasi nangyayari yun eh. Because my character is very, very deep. Malalim yung sugat niya sa buhay niya.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he was abused as a kid. He grew up as this kind of street rat, you know, fending for himself, just trying to survive talaga.
Okay.
And, you know, I tried to implement that in my life, not really doing it, but then experiencing it in a psychological perspective, like, okay, if I were put in this situation, diba, what would I have done? What would have I done? Diba? How would I attack this? Mm-hmm. And what are the scars in particular that whenever I talk to somebody, there are triggers, diba? There are things I don't want to talk about. I hide. There's this big wall in front of me all the time. I don't really get to open up to people as Connor in Los Bastardos. So it was kind of this.
Wasn't it challenging, though, to find, like, those certain emotions that you couldn't necessarily totally relate to with your character, but
hence the scene studies. So at night, you know, even when I'm not in taping, I still consider it as work because I go to the gym. But it's part of my work, my job. I have to maintain my body. Same time when I get home, I relax. Then I watch movies. But I study the scenes. I study the characters. So when you study the scenes, you realize how to do these things. Okay. When even if you don't have experience, for example, walking the streets with no money, stealing things. Because I'm a con artist here, so I learned how to steal things. I learned how to fend for myself and survive without anybody else. So I trusted only myself, you know. I closed myself from everybody else. Whenever I talk to people, there's this different person there. You know, I'm not really myself. So watching movies, it gives me ideas on how to attack these things, even if I don't really have personal experiences with it. You get what I mean? There's this... form of acting, Stanislavski method. So you
I was about to ask, like, what method is that?
Yeah,
I was trying to think of it in my head. Yeah, that was
Stanislavski method. So you just give what the script asks of you, basically. That's basically what the method is.
Mm-hmm.
So if the script asks you to do this, you just have to know where you're coming from, all the scars in your life as a character, lahat ng bubog mo, lahat ng hugot, lahat ng kinakarga mong anxiety, depression, emotion, going back to when you started, when you were a kid, your whole life, talaga. So you have to write that down.
Yeah.
So every scene you do, you go back to that. So how you attack this depends on what you went through.
Sure.
You get what I mean? Yeah. So that's how it is usually. So that's how I study my roles, even if I don't really have, you know, personal experiences. Because mostly the stereotype is mga artista. Diba? Pag namalungkot sila, humuhugot sila, pag umaarte sila, nakukuha nila from personal experiences. And I don't have anything against that, but there are other methods to it. Like in Stanislavski, you study other actors, how they approach it, multiple actors, then you piece together parts of those characters to build your own character. Diba? How to attack scenes, diba? And everything. So
but
that's what I do.
Do you also do like workshops? Because the way that you're describing it, the way I see it, it's almost as if it's a very individualized, personalized type of studying that you do.
Yeah, it is individualized. It's personal, but I also went through a lot of workshops with Direk Ryan Carlos, and that was my first workshop, basic workshop. And there's this thing I, hindi ko makakalimutan sinabi niya sa akin eh. To be able to become a good actor, you have to watch movies. You have to watch any movie, all the movies, as much as you can. Watch as much as you can.
No matter the genre.
No matter the genre, no matter anything. Because you get, you learn from them. You learn from all their roles. You learn from what they're going through. Diba? Aside from that, you also learn from the people in your life. You know, like for example, if in a scene, you're gonna get angry, you're gonna get anxious, you're gonna get depressed, for example. You think about all these experiences, your friends, the lowest points in their lives, what they did, what happened to them, and how they handled it, how they got through it. So that's also, that's another way to build your character, through personal experience. You know, like yung sabi ko, yung ibang artista, yung ginagawa rin naman talaga, at nagagawa ko rin naman talaga yun. Pero yun nga, it's very personalized, but I also went through workshops. A lot of workshops. Theater was really my training ground before this.
Mm-hmm.
Got to act on stage, build my charisma, my confidence on stage, relating to people. But in TV, it's different. It's more nuanced. So, you know, siempre the camera is like there in your face, diba?
Yeah.
And they see all the movements of your eyes, your face. So you really have to show the emotion and where you're coming from in a very nuanced way. Not really. It's, in theater, it's overacting. Diba?
Yeah.
You throw the emotions to the crowd. With a camera, you just pass it on to the audience. You know, you just hand it over to them. With theater, you just bam, bam, bam. You throw it all over the place. Diba? To make them feel what you're feeling. To make them ride with what you're feeling. To be able to experience the play itself. So in TV, it's more nuanced. It's smaller movements. And I learned that in workshops. It was a hard transition because I came from theater. You know, their comment was, ang laki ng movements mo, you have to limit those movements because, you know, the camera has limits. Syempre, the borders.
Right. That.
So, yeah, it wasn't as hard as I thought it would be. Ang gagaling na mga nag-workshop sa akin, mga directors, diba? I learned a lot from them. And even during the show, yun nga, I was talking about all the cast being super supportive, like sila Jake, Joseph, and all the directors, the producers, ganyan. We'd help each other out. Like, for example, at the beginning of the show, lagi ako may eksena with Jake. So, minsan, nawawala ako, parang I'm unsure about my emotion, kung paano ko atakihin yung, ano, yung eksena. So, I asked him, bro, I need your advice. How would you attack this if it were you? Eh, because of all the workshops we've been together, we all get each and every one of our characters. So, I know where they're coming from, they know where I'm coming from. So, we write that down. Where did you come from? All the ups and downs of your characters. What happened in your life? Then, we bring all of that. Dinadala namin yun sa eksena.
Okay.
Para mas maging totoo. Diba? There's the background. Why you reacted that way. When, for example, when somebody talks about my mom, you know, there's that anxiety. Mm-hmm. You close up because you were abused. You were sold. Diba? You were neglected. So, whenever they talk about my mom, there's that nuance na I don't want to talk about her, you know?
Yeah.
That's why I'm a con artist, you know? I play different characters, super fun, because like, it's like acting inception. Acting inception, because you're acting, but then inside the show, you're acting a different character as well, diba? Right? Because I always have this wall, and I can't be myself towards other people. I could only be myself with one person, and that was my adoptive father who taught me everything I knew. So after that, I figure out who my father was, ganyan. Tapos all the anxiety build up, ganyan. But then, it all boils down to knowing where you came from. Tawag namin dyan, I'm sure you know this, emotional continuity of the character in every scene. You have to be super particular about that. Kasi pag hindi tama yung emotional continuity mo, ano eh, hindi totoo ng kalalabasan.
Okay.
Dami ko sinabi. Thank you for listening to my TED Talk.
Actually, well, because like we were so inspired also earlier by the way you were talking about acting, we figured in this episode of Man Crush Monday, we're going to do things a little differently.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a game.
Okay.
In which we give you both three scenes and three different emotions, and you're gonna pick one out from each of these jars.
Okay.
And then you're gonna act them out for us.
Fun game.
So it'll be just like a mini workshop, right?
Mini workshop. So are you gonna be acting with me, or?
I could, yeah.
You could?
Yeah. Why not? All Maybe right. I can learn a thing or two from you.
Okay. So first, so I pick two.
Yes.
Right?
Just one each from
one
each jar.
Each. Okay. Yeah. Proposing monologue. So I'm proposing to you, my love.
Yes, my love.
My love. Afraid!
Oh, this will be interesting.
Game. Put this here.
Okay.
Wait, mic. Na resort to.
Kadang.
Masaya ka naman.
When I'm with you.
Oh, sino gusto ko ba?
Parang takot ka.
Hindi naman. Gusto ko lang malaman kung masaya. Kung masaya ka talaga.
Oo naman. Isa kasama kita. Masaya naman ako.
Kasi,
ano ba naman? Hindi ka naman ganito.
Pero, gusto ko lang malaman, nag-i-enjoy ka naman. Masaya ka naman sa akin. Masaya ka sa atin.
Of course. Why would you doubt that?
Hindi ko alam. Alam mo, dami ko lang kasing iniisip eh.
Sabihin mo lang sa akin. I'm all ears. You know that I love
natatakot
you
kasi
so
ako,
much.
Natatakot kasi ako na pagsabihin ko lahat sa'yo. Baka mag-iba yung tingin mo sa akin.
Impossible. I love you so much. There's nothing at this point that you can't say that will make me change my mind.
Mahal din kita. Mahal din kita. Pero natatakot lang ako.
Sige mo na.
Will you marry me? Yes!
One more.
You can expect.
You didn't expect? Okay, next na?
Cut na ba?
Yeah.
Cut na? Okay.
Okay.
Next one. That was fun.
Sana
nag-enjoy kayo, guys.
The camera crew in the background.
Diba?
Oh, sorry. I'm picking for you. Go.
Okay, game. Ang ganda pa ng background, diba?
Mm-hmm.
Sword.
By ourselves. Your earphones
pa
lang. Oh my God. Okay. Found out you were cheated on.
From proposal. Oh, perfect segue.
Oh my God. Okay.
Transition.
Okay, so.
Pero yung emotion.
Hindi kailangan na Stanislavski nito. From experience na lang. Huh? From experience.
Well.
From experience. So, found out you were cheated on. Pero, super, oh my, super angry. Dapat lang. Okay. Angela, right?
Yes.
Angela. Where's your phone? Give me your phone.
Since when do you ask for
my phone? Give me your phone. Just give me your phone.
We've talked about this. I don't like it when a guy asks or demands phones for me because if there is no trust, there is nothing.
May nakita kasi ako eh.
Oh, ano yan?
May kausap ka. Patingin. Papakita ako sa iyo yung nakita ko. Nakita ko na, Angela.
Ano yung nakita mo? Wait, sabihin mo na lang sa akin.
Si Jeffrey! Si Jeffrey, kinakausap mo, di ba? Kaibigan ko yun, kinakausap mo siya.
So what? Wala bang nangyayari?
So what? Baby, ganun? Wala bang nangyayari sa ganun? Ha?
Baby,
nakikita kayo, no?
Let
sabihin mo na sa akin, totoo ngayon pa lang.
Sabihin mo sa akin, totoo! What the heck is wrong with you?
Sorry.
Oh, this is fun. Nice.
Yeah, nice one. You're good.
Thank you.
You just ride with it.
I just ride with what you do. This is great. All right, we have one more from each guy.
One more. Next scene, guys. This is gonna be fun. Coming out of the closet.
This could be a whole teleserie right now.
This could be like character development. Yeah. So, you know, I propose to you.
Yep.
Then you cheat on me. Then I find out I'm gay. You know, yeah. I don't need you in my life.
Wow, me, you know? Really?
I need real men in my life. Happy. So, Angela, how have you been?
Well, I'm still shaken, obviously,
yeah.
By last night.
You know, actually, that was a long time ago, so it's hard, you know, after.
Sure.
Yeah. You know, I just think about it, you know, it's in the past, Okay. And it's hard, you know, being together. At work, seeing each other every day. You know.
Where are you getting at?
I realized something, you know. I don't think we're for each other, so. No, after what happened, you know,
oh,
I'm just like, no, but I'm over it. You know. And I'm like, I'm okay with it.
Of those years I put into this relationship, you're just gonna say that you're
Angela,
over it?
I'm not happy. Okay, I'm not happy.
And you're just telling me this now?
You know why I was so mad about Jeff? You know why I was so mad about
because
Jeff?
Because he was your best friend, which by the way.
Because I loved him. Because I love him. And I'm happy with him. I'm
with
so
him?
Happy. I'm happy with
him. Since when were you
Angela,
with him?
I'm gay. I'm gay. And I'm happy about it. Okay? I mean, we've been together for so long and you've always thought I was like metrosexual and everything. But no.
Yeah,
okay? But I love men. And I'm happy. I'm so happy.
You were never
okay?
happy with me.
And cut.
That was really good. Oh my God.
Thank you. That was fun.
Yeah,
I couldn't be
fun.
Like gay because you know coming out of the closet and everything. That was fun. Thank you guys.
Yes.
Thank you, Angela.
Thank you so much
for being so game. It was so fun.
Yeah, okay. This was
our
great.
Mini acting workshop.
Yeah, first of hopefully many.
Mm-hmm. And you know, actually, what you did was really good because, you know, one of the things with acting is you have to break down all your barriers, all your walls.
Sure.
To be able to open up to your fellow actor, to your co-actors. Like what you did, Karina, you know. I didn't really give you any cues. I just did it and you just rode along with it without any, you know, I was touching, I was holding you, just, you know, other actors, actresses wouldn't be comfortable with that, you know, with their fellow actors not telling them what they're going to do and they just do it. But sometimes they get startled about, oh, he's doing this. Wait, direct, hindi natin napag-usapan to like that. Sometimes, okay, and that's wrong, you know. You just have to go with the emotion, because that's how it becomes real.
It's so much easier, though.
It's so much easier, diba?
Because you yourself are the actor, and I think because you're the one almost initiating the scene, so it's kind of
easy for me. You were great. You were initiating the conversations, diba? Like you were adding to the story and everything.
Yeah.
Galing. Hands for Angela, guys. Galing.
For Josh, of course.
Yeah, okay. So thank you for that game. Super fun. Masaya.
This actually concludes our episode.
Really?
Today.
Talaga?
Yes.
Yun lang? Wala pa. Ipaghalo-halo natin. So, super angry.
Three emotions in one.
Super angry na, coming out of the closet. Bakla ako!
Part 2 na yan.
Part 2 na.
So,
That was fun. Thank
is there anything you want to say to everyone watching?
To everyone watching, thank you for having me here. Thank you for having me as your guest for Monday.
Man Crush Monday,
guys. So thank you. My hair is all messed up now. Anyway, thank you for having me here. I just want to promote my show, Los Bastardos. That's every day, Monday to Friday, after Kaden ng Ginto. Marami pang mangyayari dyan, guys. And thank you for the support. My fans, thank you for all the love, for all the support ever since the beginning. Talaga, grabe. My family, I love you so much. My cast members, grabe, thank you for all the support, the guidance, diba? I wouldn't be here without all of you guys, so thank you and I love you all.
So heartwarming. I love it. Okay, so thank you to everyone who has watched this episode of Man Crush Monday. And in case you missed any part, you can always click back on this link to rewatch from the beginning. So for updates on Josh and our series, just visit us on our website. That is www.lifestyle.abs-cbn.com. You can also check us out on our Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. That is at ABS-CBN Lifestyle. Special thanks, of course, to Destino Beach Club Dive Resort and Hotel for having us. And special thanks to Angie Cruz for our hair and makeup. So stick around for the next coming weeks because we are going to bring you even more guys to check out on Man Crush Monday. So bye.
See you guys.
Okay.
Yeah.